Good.
Congratulations.
Hey, Facebook family. Happy to have y'all here with us tonight. Janice was on a Zoom call for a gender reveal for one of the teachers she teaches with. And they're having a little girl. So we're a little later tonight because that started at 6. So they revealed the gender. She's telling everybody goodbye. But we're going to get started without her. Although Blanche is lonely because she's looking through the door. So tonight, don't really have a theme, but just kind of a little something going on that thought we would do songs that started out as one thing and ended up being something different. And so the song for me that I'm going to start with is called History is Lunch. And there's a book written by a fellow named Alan Germanis. And it's called The Oldest Confederate. Oldest Living Confederate Widow Tells All. And it had some great lines in it. But my favorite line was when somebody asked the oldest living Confederate widow what it felt like to live through so much history. And she basically schooled them on what history really was. And she said, history is the bad beans that somebody ate at lunch that went through them really fast when they were trying to take a nap in the middle of the day getting ready for war and ended up in the woods getting rid of those beans, and they thwarted the enemy's plans to sneak up on the camp. And she said, when it comes right down to it, history, what is history? History is lunch. So this is my interpretation of history as lunch. Woke up this morning, couldn't find my shoes, forgotten where I left them, and I'm the only one who knew. Wasn't the first time, but I wish it were the last, 'cause every day I see another piece of my past. They say history is Abe Lincoln.
History is lunch. to reposition my camera so I can see the raccoon in case it comes out.
Oh, no, I was fixing to say, we need to make sure we see the raccoon. Janice even bought Blanche a...
stuffed raccoon.
A stuffed raccoon, which she has wants to have nothing to do with. So Janice will probably be playing with the stuffed raccoon. Pictures to follow.
We love you too, Aunt Judy.
So this next song started out as what it was, a song about working 9 to 5. But just found out recently that when Jane Fonda had asked Dolly Parton if she would be part of the 9 to 5 cast, Dolly said sure she would do it, but only if she could write the theme song, because she figured if the movie flopped, she'd at least make something out of it from the songwriting royalties. And so that's how this song came about.
Ron Hurd says you have some serious musical skills.
Thank you, Ron Hurd.
Zeb, you could come by instead of just watching.
I know, Zeb. We could socially distance and put you right out here with the keyboard.
That's right.
You could have your own segments. So come on over. You done hunkered down with Harry. Come 6 at 6 with us. If you don't know Zeb Matthews, look him up. Harry Connick Jr. had him on his show, Hunker Down with Harry, when Zeb had recorded. I don't remember what he recorded, but it was a great song.
It was a good song.
Bring Me to the Rock. Mm-hmm. So this next song is doing 2 back-to-back non-originals. And it's a song that I hadn't thought about in a while, and then I thought about it today, about songs that have meanings and mean something different. And this one actually means what it is, better than a hallelujah. But it's all about things that we don't think bring praise, are things that are blessings, but yet they are. It's an old song, not like a hymn kind of song, but an older song. A lullaby in a mother's tears in the dead of night, better than a hallelujah sometimes. God loves a drunkard's cry and a soldier's plea to let him die, better than a hallelujah sometimes. We pour out
dying man giving up the fight. More than a hallelujah sometimes. The tears of shame for what's been done. Silence when the words won't come. Are better than a hallelujah sometimes. We pour out our misery. God just hears a melody. Beautiful the mess we are. Beyond his cries of a breaking.
Amy Grant today.
Ron Hurd said he's going to come sing with you in case he says no, no, no.
Oh, come on, Ron. Between he and Wiley.
Uh-huh.
We would be a force to be reckoned with.
Yeah, as soon as the quarantine's lifted. It'd be a,
yep.
A trio, you, Ron, and Wiley.
Yeah. So actually I'm doing 3 non-me songs in a row. And this one, I was reminded of it recently by my favorite man to never be my husband. Favorite, I bet the best husband I've ever had.
Airman.
God bless, he's ever in the
airman.
In the helicopter, yep. So, a few years ago, quite a while ago, the Reverend Charles Ward and Aaron Sibley and I rode over to Faraday, Louisiana, of all places, and went to a songwriter conference where Tia Sillers was on the panel, and she's the lady who, along with Mark Sanders, wrote "I Hope You Dance," which was made famous by LeeAnn, Womack. And today I saw that Mandisa sang it. Gladys Knight sang it. Anybody who's anybody has sang this song. So now it's my turn to mess it up. But the Reverend reminded me that Tia had said during that conference that the best thing that you have to do as a songwriter is dare to suck. You have to dare to be horrible in order to get better. And I think that's a true testament to life, is sometimes we have to dare to suck. I think I'm with that t-shirt. Because we don't know how to get up and we don't know how to fly until we fall. And Tia said that she wrote this song, or the idea came to this song, was she was sitting on a beach just wanting quiet and solitude. And this person drives up in this huge Hummer, barreling down the beach, pulls up, gets out of the Hummer on his cell phone and starts talking loud and cussing and making lots of noise. And just being really loud, and then gets back in the Hummer and storms off. And she said, "I sure hope that guy feels small by the ocean." And that's where this song came from some guy making her aggravated and mad because he was taking away her quiet time at the ocean. So I'll never listen to the line, "I hope you still feel small when you stand beside the ocean again," without thinking of a big black Hummer coming up with some really mad little guy in it. Street.
Garden District is wonderful.
Yes, it is. So my apologies to Tia Sillers for wrecking her song, but I do love the song. It's a good song. And again, I'll never forget it, that dare to suck. So there was my opportunity to dare to suck right there. So, in thinking of songs that we have that mean one thing and could mean another, I've played this song a couple times on 6 and 6, and I used to hardly ever play it because I didn't really like it, and then I started playing it again, and I do like it. And it started out from a praise and worship concert that Janice and I went to, that I just kept sitting there thinking, this band is really good, but they keep saying the same thing over and over and over. And I thought, I'm going to write a really snarky song about it. And in my snarkiness, I realized that I've maybe found a truth in life. Because over and over is kind of how we live life and how we play out life. We either make the same mistakes over and over and wonder why we're not getting where we want to be, or we fall down over and over, keep getting up over and over, keep on moving forward over and over. Nothing you'll ever do that'll make you unworthy.
David Carson says he likes your snarky.
Thanks, David. I think we have that in common sometimes. Mm-hmm.
Tiffany Lester loved that song.
Oh, thanks, Tiff. So this song is exactly what it's about and what it says. But I wrote it, and it's an acapella song, which means I'm not going to play the guitar with it. But it is a song that we started. Judy Ginsburg reached out to me and wanted to start a threshold choir where you bring comfort to families and people who are on the threshold of this life and going into the next. And we sing them on over, is what the threshold choir is. And so I wrote this song for the threshold choir, but then the more I think about it, there's lots of anxiety out there right now, and I think not knowing if you have germs on your hand or if there's a disease in your house is really bothering folks. And we're also stressed about other people not doing what they're supposed to do, and how can we make everybody do what they're supposed to do and get our economy back going and get our hair cut or our nails did. When it really comes down to keeping folks safe and alive. And it's all about our journey and how we find things in this life. So this is my dog walking by, and our dogs don't like it at all. Blanche thinks she is a bad
bee. Sure, she can be bad when she's up here on the porch by you.
So this next song is called Your Destination. It doesn't have to be your final destination, but we're all on a journey right now, and we're all walking it together.
Ruby's gonna bark as long as she can see that dog.
I know. So we're not gonna wait her out because it might be a little long.
I wish you light. I wish you light to find your way. Light to find your way. Peace, may you find peace. May you find peace on your journey. Peace on your journey. Love, only love. When you reach your destination, when you reach your destination. Love, only love. When you reach your destination, when you reach your destination. Love, light, and peace. When you reach your destination, when you reach your destination. Love, light, and peace. When you reach your destination, when you reach your destination. Only love.
So tonight I wish you love, light, and peace as we all continue our journey in the darkness of this COVID, of this pandemic. And remember that you're not going through this alone, even though it feels like it. And that we're all going to walk out this other side together. And you can push folks away and you can fuss at folks. But love is what will keep us together. And love, light, and peace is what we need right now. So wash those hands. Stay at home. Because this ain't over. It's getting better, but it ain't over. And we still need to keep the curve flattening until it's a straight line. And I don't do straight that well. But this, I want to be a straight line. So wash those hands, stay at home if you can, take every precaution if you're going out and working. But stay connected with other folks. Let them know that you love them and that God loves them and there's nothing they can do about it. And And there's nothing they've ever done and nothing they'll ever do to make them unworthy. Because we're all in this together, whether we're in a pandemic or not. So in the words of my great friend Rick Adams, we're good here. Y'all good?